Great game on the menu tonight, folks, between the Rutgers Scarlet Knights and the Michigan State Spartans. And here's a look at our Star Watch comparison. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
We have two excellent players matched at the point guard position. It's going to be interesting to watch how they each try to get their team involved throughout the game.
And now for the tip. And we're off and running into the first half. The Spartans, number two in the polls right now, Dick.
Hey, when you're among the top 25, it really gets all your boosters excited.
Can't connect. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
On the right side. He tries the jumper. Busts the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. He attempts the three, missed the jumper. Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Got it. Williams handles the pass. He shoots from the top of the circle. Off the mark. Working it around the perimeter. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock.
And the fans love it, man. They love it. Our house, baby. Our house.
Looking for a good shot. From the corner, knocks it down.
Try to go inside.
He attempts the jump shot and come up short. Johnson receives the pass. Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. He pulls up with a jumper. Scores it. Takes it strong to the hoop.
He has all the tools to play down low. He can put a lot of pressure on the defense.
Now on the run. Now trying to feed the low block. Goes up. Off the mark. Nice rejection. That one finds its way out of bounds, but we'll keep it right here. The jumper. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Looks at the three. And score it. About 6 minutes remaining. Number 20 handles the pass. They look to get it to the inside. In the lane. Missed it. Looking for a good shot. For two. Nails the J. Here comes the ball screen. Williams receives the pass. There's the block. Inside. Puts up the J. Jumper won't go. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Jumper knocked it down. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Williams receives the ball. They work the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Can't connect. Number 11 takes the feed. We're at the 4 minute mark with a rejection. Off target. Pushing in transition. They're working around the perimeter.
There's the trap.
The ball goes out of bounds. Let's check out this jumper one more time. Nice drop step. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Three minutes left on the game clock. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
Gave it up. He puts up the J. Busts the jumper. Takes the jumper. Missed the jumper. Johnson handles the pass. On the outside. Puts up the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
A little two-man action. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Nails the jumper. About 2 minutes remaining. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the baseline.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot? Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up for two. Too strong. the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. That was nice. One minute left to go. Inside. Tries for two. Shot off. Out on the wing.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket. Knocks it down. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities. Up and inside.
He goes up with it.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Tries to beat the clock. Can't get the shot to drop. At the end of the first half, the Spartans trail by five. Before we go any further, let's take a moment here and have a look at our game summary.
I've been really impressed with just how hard both teams are playing. These numbers show you how they've been performing.
Looks like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. They'll work it around the arc. Puts up the jumper and score it. This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
Wow, listen to those fans. The crowd is thunderous.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
On the outside. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Spartans have done a poor job so far pushing the ball in transition. They prefer to play up-tempo and did not do a good job of this in the first half. I overheard a member of their coaching staff saying that they've gone away from their ideal style of play. Dick, you mentioned that this would be a key for them earlier, and guess what? You were right. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Now they work it around the perimeter. Here comes the ball screen. Ward picks up the foul. First team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
Hey, underclassmen are an important part of any program. With a year under his belt, the coaching staff expects solid play from him. He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Goes up for two. He gets it to go.
Spacing.
takes a nice shot fake. He shoots the jumper. Missed it. Goins receives the pass. They go into the low block. Number 20 is charged with the layup's good and one, Dick.
Hey, that's good concentration. Taking the ball hard to the hoop, knowing that someone's going to hack you.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
He's been around for a couple of years now. He knows what he's capable of bringing to the team. This is a year when players start to transition into more of a leadership role and help get the most out of younger guys on the team.
Did he get there?
Great anticipation by the young guy.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
In the paint. Let's watch the move as he works his man and not a fadeaway jumper. Williams handles the pass. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
For two, off the glass and no good. Can't get it to go. For the deuce. They wanted an offensive interference call and don't get it. On the dribble, gives it up. Takes his jumper off the mark. Gave it up. Six minutes left on the game clock. Tries for two. He gets the bucket. Moving it around the perimeter. There's a double team waiting there. He tries the jumper. The missed shot. For the bucket. He makes the shot. Way out on the right wing. Stop and pop. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know, he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
With the J, jumper won't go. Goins receives the ball. About 5 minutes remaining. A little two-man action. Buries it. In terms of balanced teams, what might we expect from them game to game, Dick?
They try to really get balanced in that they'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high percentage shots. Great defensive play, rotating over. Played that screen really well up on top.
Williams receives the pass. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Missed the jumper. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Goes up for two. Drains the shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
He shoots from the corner. Rims out. Johnson handles the pass. Jumper. Nope. For two. With the layup. About 3 minutes remaining. This one might go down to the final buzzer.
In close games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important.
Goes up with it. Off the mark. Goes up for two. Off the glass. Working it around the perimeter. With the shot. Perfectly executed. You always want your players going hard to the basket like that, right, Dick?
He has all kinds of moves, and we saw just about all of them on that drive. A good-looking 2 points.
Looking for a good shot. We're at the two-minute mark. He attempts the three. He misses the J. Number 20 is whistled for the foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Shot. A great trap initiated by the defense. Williams receives the ball. Well, this man's in trouble. He takes it away. Tries for two. Lays it up. Momentary look from three-point land. He tries the jumper. Off the mark with a shot. Trying to feed the low block.
I love that block shot, Brad. Really gives you a lot of momentum.
We're at the one-minute mark. Here's a double team. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. Should they call a timeout now?
No, let's score quickly here, then worry about the clock. Either way, they have to score quickly.
Coach calls a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment. Timeout's been called, so let's check in with Aaron.
With limited time remaining, it's very important that the players have a clear understanding of what the coach wants them to do when they return to the floor. They'll have to be on the same page, or else it could cost them the game.
Well, now that everyone knows what to do, it's time to get back on the courts.
Indeed, Mr. Nessler. The coach has everyone up to speed on where they need to be and what they need to do. But it'll be up to the players on the court to get the job done.
Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
That makes it a 4-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
Takes the shot.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. And the clock stopped with a foul. Foul, and that's stops the clock again. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Number 11 goes to the line for the first time. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Hits the second shot.
It's all about scoring here if they want a chance at winning.
We're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. Dick's 6-point lead here.
They have to keep applying the pressure if they want to win this one, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. That's an ill-advised shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
He goes to the line. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Second shot, good. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.